Are you anxious, depressed, distracted, worried about your cancer risk? The enzyme COMT could be relevant. Here's how to find out if it is for you and what to do about it. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmittels, just tell me what works. And here we're going to talk about COMT. In the last few videos, I've been using the Stratagene report. I'll link to the video about how to get it, but I'm going to assume we all have a Stratagene report for the rest of this video. If you look at my Stratagene report, on the second page, you go down to the bottom, you will see the third to last and second to last lines are for COMT. This is an enzyme that uses methyl groups from the methylation process to methylate a few things, but chief among them are dopamine and estrogen. And you can see that there are two different mutations. The V158M mutation is the one where most of the research is. There's another one that has less research behind it. And you can see over here that I'm heterozygous for each of them, meaning I have plus minus one of those variants from one of my parents, but not the other. Now, I think it's a little bit deceptive that it shows it yellow here because it indicates intermediate risk. Actually, to be plus minus for that, to be yellow for that, means that you are in the middle 50% of the population. If you are plus plus and red, it means that you're in the lowest 25% of the population for your genetic ability to use that enzyme. And if you're green minus minus, it means you're in the top 25% of the population in your genetic ability to use that enzyme. To be plus minus and yellow means that you're in the 50% more or less majority right in the middle where you are in the center of the sweet spot. So what does this mean? If you're red plus plus, it means that you have less COMT activity on a genetic basis. You will be less able to methylate dopamine, and that is going to make you more mentally rigid. That means that it's more difficult for you to let go of things. It's more difficult for you to switch mental states. It's more difficult for you to see something that you're not currently paying attention to and shift your attention to it. While that might actually be a good thing when you're trying to focus on analytical or creative work, it can be a bad thing if what gets into your mind is an anxious thought or a depressing thought because it might be really hard for you to let go of it. On the other hand, actually, I should also point out that if you have low COMT activity, you are going to methylate estrogen at a lower rate, and that makes you less able to clear the estrogen metabolites that are capable of doing damage to DNA and contribute to a portion of the estrogen-related cancer risk. Now, if you have the opposite case where you're green minus minus and you're in the 25% highest activity of that enzyme, then that's probably really good for your estrogen metabolism, but it can also predispose you to be very distracted and to be not very good at focusing. Now, if you look at these mental traits, if your nutrition is good, it's just a personality variation. And that's why we would expect there to be this distribution where 50% is in the middle, 25% is high, and 25% is low. Because if you get too high, you can't focus as well. And if you get too low, you get too mentally rigid and you get stuck on things and you ruminate. You could, of course, swing back and forth because it's not just your COMT genes that matters. In order to methylate dopamine, you need the support of the methylation system. And in order to not over-methylate dopamine, you need your glycine buffer in place. These are the things that I talked about in the MTHFR videos. I'll link to the three relevant videos in the description of this one. But basically, if you're not following the methylation protocol to support the methylation process and to have the glycine buffer system in place, then you will be much more vulnerable to falling off one or the other end, depending on where you are. In other words, if you're in the bottom 25% of COMT activity and you're deficient in your methyl groups because you're not providing enough choline, enough folate, enough B12, enough betaine, etc., then you might go from a personality trait of low COMT to a pathological level of being neurotically or psychotically mentally rigid. So what you want to do is you want to take advantage of your personality trait to be really good at focusing, for example, but you want to give enough nutrition to where it stays a personality trait and not a problem. On the other hand, if you have high COMT activity, then you could go off the deep end in distraction if you don't have the glycine buffer system in place, because when you do get your methyl groups, you methylate dopamine too much, especially when you have a really robust supply, because that buffer system with the glycine is not in place. So as long as you get all aspects of that nutrition right, you should stay within the boundaries of healthy personality variation. And you should also be able to support the methylation of estrogen to get whatever protective effects you can get out of methylation for that purpose. And even if you're in right smack in the middle for COMT, it doesn't remove those risks, because even if you have a normal COMT enzyme, not having enough methyl groups can still predispose you to too much mental rigidity. And not having the glycine buffer system in place can still predispose you to too much distraction or not enough focus. So it's always important to get the nutrition. It's just that your COMT genotype biases you towards one set of problems or another when that nutrition is not in the right place. And please, please, oh please, if you're yellow plus minus like me, just know that you're right in the middle of normal. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.